Hello and welcome in this session on citation and referencing style in research. In this session, I'm going to discuss about the changes which have been proposed in the 7th manual of American Psychological Association, which was released in 2020. I want to clarify that this presentation is based on APA 7th edition guidelines, and it is for the use of researchers or research students only. No one can use it for any commercial benefit. Dear friends, we all know that American Psychological Association APA has introduced its 7th edition of the publication manual in 2020. And this version has came after almost 10 years of the 6th edition, which we were following from last 10 years. APA manual is basically being used religiously in the education, psychology, and many other social sciences disciplines for research purpose. So, what is new in the 7th edition? This new edition basically addresses the quantitative, qualitative, and mixed method articles, student papers, dissertations, and theses. It talks about bias-free language guidelines to encourage authors to write about people with inclusivity and respect. This edition also talks about the mechanics of a style. It talks about punctuation, capitalization, abbreviations, numbers, statistics, how it can be used in text. All these things have been suggested. And the in-text citation process have been simplified as compared to the 6th edition. In this edition, new guidelines have been given to cite the recorded or unrecorded traditional knowledge or the oral traditions of the indigenous people. Examples of paraphrasing are given to demonstrate how to achieve clear attribution without over-citation. And new guidelines and guidance is provided in this manual on how to format quotations from research participants. This manual also standardized the presentations of digital object identifiers, DOIs, and URLs. New formatting guidance is being provided in this edition for the annotated bibliographies and to refer the audiovisual materials such as YouTube video, PowerPoint slides, lecture notes, TED Talks, social media posts, comments on social media, web pages, websites, Twitter, how you can cite all these things in your research. All these things have been discussed in detail in this manual. It is very lengthy manual. If you see, it's hard copy, it is around more than 700 pages. So let us start with citation. We all know that in research, whenever we write a review or we write our introductory part or we need the justification of the research, we do cite many researches. So this manual proposes that in in-text citation, the author date citation system should be followed, in which a brief in-text citation directs readers to a full reference list entry. Each work cited must appear in the reference list, and each work in the reference list must be cited in the text, either in text, table, figure, footnote, or appendix. So there should be a matching between the citation within the text and in the reference list. You cannot do, you have cited only 10 researches in your text and at the end of the paper you have given 20 or 3 references. No. Similarly, if you have not covered all the in-text citation in the reference list, then it is a mismatching. Both paraphrases and quotations require citation. Many times you cite quotations, but you forgot or missed to cite the paraphrases, but paraphrases also require citation. When I'm talking about citation, basically this manual talks about two types of citation. The first is parenthetical citation. In this citation, it is proposed that you should provide the author and date in the parenthesis of the paragraph separated by a comma. And if the parenthetical citation comes at the end of a sentence, put the period or the ending punctuation after the closing parenthesis. Let me see an example. Here, this has been taken from Beeman et al. 2011. So Beeman et al. Is coming at the end with the date 2011. Date means the year. Another form of citation is narrative citation. Many times you don't write the name of the author and year at the end, but you put it in your narrative. So you need to mention the author in the narrative of your paper, followed by the date in the parenthesis. Like Hargett et al. 2018 endorsed. It is also acceptable to write the date in narrative without parenthesis when it makes sense to do it. For example, if you are not using the bracket, you can write according to a 2017 review by Bokan and Margolis. So there are two ways, either Hargett et al. 2018 endorsed. So here you put date with the name, or you can put date before according to a 2017 review by Bokan and Margolis. So both ways you do narrative citation. So these are two examples of narrative citation. Similarly, if there are more than one author for narrative citation, you can write studies by Warren, Goodzer et al. And Stone and Stannis have examined so and so. So this is also one way of in-text citation. So when we do in-text citation, we should follow certain guidelines, like the spelling of author's name and publication date in reference list entries match with those in the corresponding in-text citation. So you cannot do the error in putting different spelling of the author names or putting different publication dates. Cite only work that you have read and the ideas that you have incorporated into your writing. So no need to cite more than what you have cited. The work you cite may provide key background information, support or dispute your thesis, or offer critical definitions or data. Readers may find a long string of citation difficult to understand. So don't give a long string of citation, especially if they are using assistive technologies like screen reader, because screen reader may do error in reading the long string of citations. You should also keep in your mind that include only those citations needed to support your immediate point. Cite primary sources whenever possible and cite secondary sources sparingly if primary source is not there. Cite sources to documents all fact figure that you mentioned and that are not common knowledge. So whatever is not coming under common knowledge should be cited in your research paper or your thesis. To cite a specific part of a source, provide an author date citation for the work plus information about a specific part. Even when source cannot be retrieved, for example, because they have personal communications, still credit to them in the text. However, if personal communications are there and you cannot retrieve them, they may not be the part of your end reference list. Here again, there is one change in the 7th edition for citation. If the work has been done by one or two authors, you should include the surname of the authors in every citation, even in the first citation. If there are three or more authors, you need to include only first author plus et al. In every citation, even from the first in-text citation. The year in the in-text citation should match with the year in the reference list entry, I have already told you. And use only the year in the in-text citation, even if the reference list has the more specific dates like year, month or day. For example, if you are citing a newspaper article. So in in-text citation, you put only the author name or the if it is editorial, the editor name with the year. But when you give the complete reference in the reference list, you put the month and the day also. If there is work which has no date, you are not able to retrieve the date, then use n.d. in the in-text citation. And for works which have not been published but accepted for publication, you should use in press in place of year. If you are repeating a citation, then you again need to show entire citation. In APA style, we do not follow IBID dot. So don't put IBID dot in APA style. Include author's name and year in every parenthetical in-text citation. You also keep in your mind that if you are citing multiple works by the same author or the authors, regardless of the publication year, include the date in every in-text citation to prevent ambiguity. So you cannot miss the date. Each in-text citation must correspond to only one reference list entry and don't include suffix such as junior in the in-text citation, but in complete reference list you should keep it. For works with unknown author, include the title and year of the publication in the in-text citation. I will give you all the examples. So here is just the summary what I have told you till now, that if there is one author, you can write in parenthetical citation Luna, 2020 within the bracket, but in narrative citation you will write Luna, then bracket will start 2020, explains, given ideas and all that. So this is a very important thing. If there are two authors, put and in the between the surnames and the comma and the year in parenthetical. But when you are giving it at narrative, the and is not symbolic here, and is A-N-D. So please keep it in your mind that when you are doing parenthetical citation, what kind of and should come, and what do you are giving narrative citation, what kind of and should come. If there are three or more authors, I have already told you, you should keep the first author. If there is a group or organization and not the author, then put the full name of the organization and its short form or abbreviation in the first citation. In subsequent citations, you can use only abbreviations. And if it is an organization, then put the name of the organization without abbreviations. This manual also talks about what kind of language you should use when you are writing your research paper or your thesis or dissertation. So this manual talks about that they are trying to reduce the bias around the topics such as gender, age, disability, racial and ethnic identity, sexual orientation, as well as being sensitive to the labels or describing individuals at the appropriate level of specificity. So if you see, first time in the seventh manual, a singular they or their is endorsed as a new gender neutral pronoun. We all know they and their are not singular pronoun, they are plural pronoun. But this manual proposes that in place of using he or she, you should use they. In place of his or her, you should use their. For example, there are two sentences. A researcher's career depend on how often he or she is cited. A researcher's career depend on how often they are cited. You know, a researcher is one, but here they are using the they as singular, not as plural. So this is a very significant change in this seventh edition, which every researcher should keep in mind while they are writing the paper. The second thing which they have suggested, that don't use adjectives as nouns to label a group of people. Descriptive phrases should be preferred. For example, the poor, the rich, the urban, such terms should be replaced by, for example, the poor has been replaced by people living with poverty, people living in cities. So such type of descriptive phrases should be used. Similarly, instead of broad categories of age, you should use exact age range. Generally, we keep the two age range, initial, first and last, like below 25, above 65 or above 75. No, there should be a specific age range. So the manual is suggesting that people in the age range of 60 to 70 years old is the correct way to use the descriptive phrases. Now let me talk about some basic setups like fonts. Earlier, we were writing mostly the papers either in Arial or in Times Roman. But if you see now in the seventh manual, they have talked about two types of fonts. We all know there are two types of fonts, sans serif fonts and serif fonts. Sans serif fonts are the fonts which don't have edges. So they are proposing that you can write in your paper 11-point Calibri, 11-point Arial or 10-point Lucida Sans Unicode. Similarly, if you are using a serif font, then you can use 12-point Times New Roman, which you are already using, 11-point Georgia or 10-point Computer Modern. So these fonts have been suggested for writing your paper. They have also suggested about the line spacing. Now in your paper or in your thesis, everything, whether it is title page, abstract, heading, footnote, quotation, reference, table or figure number, title, note, appendix, everything should be in double space. So now one line space, one and half line space have gone with the seventh manual. It is also suggested in the manual that do not add any extra line before and after the heading or between the paragraphs. Sometimes we do this purposely or by mistake, that when we put the heading of our paper or our dissertation, after that we give one space, we put one extra line, then we start writing our paragraphs. So there is no need to put any extra line between or after or before the heading. Then the margins. This manual has suggested that use 1-inch margin or 2.54 centimeter margin on all the sides, means top, bottom, left or right. But it's also cautioned that if any university, any organization, any institution, any journal has given any specific format, then you need to follow that. Then the paragraph. The manual has suggested that you indent the first line of every paragraph by 0.5 inch using the tab key of your computer or the automatic paragraph formatting function, which you can use in your word processing program. After the first line of every paragraph, you leave all remaining lines of the paragraph left aligned. So generally we have a habit that we use full justification for paragraph so that it should look nice. Both side edges should be equal. No. Now it is suggesting that first line should be intended by 0.5 inch and remaining lines of the paragraph should be left aligned and not the justified. In the reference list entry, it has been suggested that for every entry, there should be hanging intent of 0.5 inch. I will show you this when I will discuss about different referencing examples. It is also saying that use the paragraph formatting feature of your word processing program to apply a hanging intent. While we are talking about the paragraph, it is saying that following things should be always left aligned and not intended, like the first line of the abstract, label 2 and label 3 heading, table and figure number in bold, titles and notes, all these should be left aligned. Similarly, following things should be at the centrally aligned, like the paper title in bold, the byline, the affiliation of the author on the title page, course number, name, instructor's name, if it is a student assignment, then assignment due date on the title page, all these things should be at the center of the page. The section labels, if you are putting section 1, section 2, section 3, then label 1 heading should always come at the center, but label 2 and label 3 heading should come at the left alignment. Appendix labels and titles. This manual suggests that quotation and paraphrases both require citation. A quotation is basically reproduced material from another work's word to word, whereas a paraphrase restates ideas from another work in your own words. Whenever you quote or paraphrase the work of others or your own previous work, you must cite the source in order to avoid plagiarism or self-plagiarism. Start a block quotation as a new paragraph. Intend the whole quotation by 0.5 inch from the left margin using the tab key. If you are giving a long block quotation, then not only the first line, but the whole quotation should be intended by 0.5 inch from the left margin and double space in whole block quotation. So don't use quotation marks around the block quotation. If it is within the text, you can use, but if it is as a block quotation you are giving, means you are giving as a separate paragraph, then no quotation marks are required. You can use some abbreviations like P for pace and PP for pages, which is like the earlier edition. Then para for paragraphs and paras for paragraphs. If you are having pages or paragraph discontinued, then each page should be separated by comma, like 3 to 5, comma 7. For audiovisual works like the audiobooks, YouTube videos, TED Talks, TV show, you should provide the timestamp if you are giving a part. Like if you are not going to quote the whole TED Talk or YouTube video, but you want to quote only the YouTube video or the thing which have been said in the video at 1.02 minute, then it should start by 1 minute, 2 second mark. Now, let us move towards the referencing style in APA. We all know that there are four elements in APA style. First is the author. the person, people, or group who are responsible for the work, then date when the work was published or last updated, then title, name of the work, and source where the work can be retrieved. There are two things. One is digital object identifier, DOI, and another is URL. We are habitual of giving URL in reference section and we often avoid DOIs. But now the rule is saying that if there is a DOI, which is a unique and permanent identifier for any document on the internet, then you should give DOI. You can found easily DOI on the first page of an article or on the copyright page of the book or in the database record of a work. If a work has DOI, include it in the reference. If a work has DOI and URL, then include DOI in the reference. Even now you can give the DOI of the print version also. And please don't alter the format of the DOI or add any period or space at the end. The second thing is uniform resource locator. You all know the URL which we do copy when we search anything on internet. If an online work has URL but no DOI, then URL should be appear in the reference. You just copy paste the URL directly in your reference list to avoid any transcription error. Don't add any additional period after the URL as this may interfere the link functionality. And the change is that before 7th edition, we were using the word retrieved from before the URL. Now the 7th edition of APA has dropped the term retrieved from. They are saying now there is no need to write retrieved from until or unless the date of that event is to be mentioned. For the work without DOI from a non-database website, you should use URL. From the work from a database or ARIC, you should use the name of the database or archive also. The next change is that the publisher location is no longer needed in the reference list. Earlier, we were used to write the place from where the journal or the book has been published or where that publisher is. Now, for example, in this example, you can see the University News, New Delhi, AIU. Now, the New Delhi is not required. If University News, AIU is there, it is enough. Next change is that earlier it was allowed up to 7. Now, if there are more than 20 authors, then in the reference list, you need to give the surname and initials of minimum 20 authors. If DOIs are there in format, then earlier there was a format called DOI, then that is the old format. Now it starts with HTTPS. So whatever DOI is starting with HTTPS, you should refer that. The next change is that now URL are no longer preceded by retrieved from. I have already told you, unless a retrieval date is needed. The website name should be included and the web page title should be italicized. The next change is for ebook, the format, platform or device, for example Kindle, is no longer required to include in the reference. Only publisher is to be included. So earlier we were writing like this Kindle version. Now the Kindle version is not important. From where it has been published, that publisher is important. Then podcast episode or a TV series. If something like there, then there are clear guidelines to include the contributors other than authors and editors. When citing a podcast episode, the host of the episode should be included. For a TV series episode, the writer and director of that episode are cited. Let us move towards the reference list. Begin the reference list on a new page after the text. Always place section level references in bold at the top of the page and centrally aligned. Arrange entries in alphabetical order by the surname of the first author followed by the initial of the author given name. Double space the entire reference list both within as well as between the entries. Apply a hanging indent of 0.5 inch to each reference list entry. Let us see some examples. Suppose the same author, Patel SN, has to be referred at many places. So ND will come first, then the year will come first, which is earlier. If there are two publications in the same year, then A and B, A will come first. If there is an accepted publication but not printed yet, it will come with in press at the last. Let us see one more example. If there is one author, it will come first. And if the same author has written a paper with another author even the earlier year, but because the author, now there are two authors, so the second will come at end. If there are years, then you know the year which is earlier will come first. If there are one author common but another author is changing, then it should be followed the alphabetical order. So Duncan will come first because D comes before R. In another, Raymond's is there, so R comes after D, right? These are few abbreviations which are being used in the reference list, like ED dot for edition, REVED for revised edition, second edition, editors, translators, narrators, ND not dated, P and PP page and pages, para and paras, paragraph and paragraphs, volume and volumes for volumes, NO for numbers, PT for parts, technical report, tech rep, supplements, SUPPL for supplements. So these are few abbreviations which are being used in reference section. With this, we have completed the basic guidelines. Let us see some examples of referencing. These examples I have taken from the original manual. Let us talk about the journal article. So we all know that if there is a journal article, we keep on referencing is like this, and we put the name of the journal in italics, like here in this example you can see Psychological Review. But here remember, you can see that Psychological Review as well as 126, the volume, both are italicized. So issue will be straight, issue is not italicized, but the volume and journal name both will be italicized and nothing like retrieved from. You see in this example again, because the first example of Macaulay was with DOI and this example is with URL, not with DOI. But again you notice the name Journal of Post-Secondary Education and Disability 31. Whole this portion is italicized and all other things are not italicized. And you can see the second line in the entry is intended by 0.5 inch. In both the entries you can notice it. If you are going to refer a magazine or a newspaper article, then you can write this. The name of the magazine or the title of the newspaper will be in italics. Then if it is a number of authors, more than 20 authors, then 19 author will come with surname. Rest authors will be covered in dot, dot, dot. And the last author will again come with the surname, year. And again, you can see the name of the journal in italics. If a journal article is in press, then you cannot write the issue or the date, but you can write the author in press, title of the paper and name of the journal in italics. A magazine article, you need to italicize the title of the magazine. Similarly, if there is a blog post, then you need to give the URL of the blog with the name of the blog in italic. Here you can see SCI dash ad dot is in italics. If there is an online periodical or blog post and someone has commented on that, then the person who has commented will come first, and the person on whose post the comment has come second. So KS in NJ, KS is the commenter and NJ is the author of that post. KS in NJ, year and date from this article, the whole comment will come, then you will write in the big bracket, comment on the article so and so, and where you have seen this comment, whether it is an online periodical article, blog post or newspaper article, you put that name in italics, like here the Washington Post is in italics. If it is a book, you all know that if it is a book, the name of the book will be italicized. It is the same as earlier, and only the publisher name will come, not the place of the publication, like here in Routledge. Here you can see another example, which is an edited book. So the name of the editor will come, and if it is an edited book, it will come like this. If it is an audio book, then you need to write in big bracket that it is audio book. If it is a book chapter in an edited book, author of the chapter, then title of the chapter, in, then name of the editors, and you see that when you are citing the name of the authors, their surnames are coming first, like Aaron L., Botila M., Robert T. But when you are giving the details of the editors, their first name and second name are coming first in short, and surname are coming last, like R.F. Suttonick, P. Ojalwaski, Kublius, or F.C. Warren. So these two things you should keep in mind. Then the name of the book should be in italic. Let us see a few more examples. Like a Wikipedia entry, you need to put the title of the entry, then date and year, because Wikipedia is a dynamic page, it gets changes, anyone can change. That's why the date is required here and the link. Online dictionary, if it is, sometimes dictionary may not have date, so you write the name of the dictionary.nd, then whatever you have taken from there, then what is the name of actual dictionary, that will come in italics. And when you have retrieved, because again, dictionary is a dynamic thing, online dictionary especially, so they keep on changing the words, so you need to put the date here. So retrieved is required in two cases, if it is a dynamic page, or if you think that the information which is available here may not be available after some time. If it is a report by a government agency or the other organization, you should write Australian Government Productivity Commission, so it is the agency, then the report, then title of the report and link. If it is an individual author for a government agency, then first the author will come, then the title of the report will come, then the name of the agency will come. So here is a change in style. Similarly, if you are going to cite the conference proceedings, the style is same, name of the author or presenter, on which date and year that person has presented it, title of the presentation in italics, you write in big bracket conference presentations, then you give the name of the conference and the URL. Similarly, if it is conference proceeding, you should give the title of the author of the paper, then the name of the paper, then proceedings, title will come in italics, with italics in volume number, and if there is DOI, DOI, if there is URL, URL. Similarly, for unpublished dissertation or work, you write the name of the author, year, when it was submitted, title of the dissertation or thesis, and you write unpublished doctoral dissertation, and where it was submitted, name of that university. Similarly, if you are taking any dissertation or thesis from database, nowadays people take from ERIC, or sometimes people take from even in India, Shodhganga. So you write the name of the author or the original contributor for that thesis, then the title in italics, then what is the number of its publication on that database. Then you write whether it is doctoral dissertation or master dissertation, where it was originally submitted, and include the name of the database from where you have taken it. Film. Film will be referred with the name of the director. So who is the director? Then year, the name of the film. Who is the producer? That agency will come. If it is a TV series, again the executive producer or the producer or the director, whosoever is the responsible person for that, will come with the range of the year because it was a series. If you are going to refer a particular episode, write the name of the writer and director both, on which date this episode was telecasted, then name of the TV series episode, and what was the whole series. If it is a MOOC course and you are going to refer the online course or massive open online course, then who are the authors of the course or who are the course coordinators? Sometimes you may have date, sometimes you may not have the date when this course was actually launched. So put it ND, the name of the course in italics. If it is a MOOC, put it in the bracket MOOC in capitals. Then the platform, here it is Coursera, and the link. If you are not going to refer the whole course and if you are going to refer only one lecture, then the person who has delivered the lecture, the year, the episode 2, episode 3, lecture 1, lecture 2, then it is MOOC lecture. Then in whose course it is. So here the course coordinator's name will come at second and the name of the course in italics. Then the platform, like here it is edX, and then the URL of the page. If it is a YouTube video, you need to refer it. who is the owner of that video. That may be a university or a person. On which date it was uploaded, you can get the detail from that YouTube video, then the title of the video and the link. If it is whole YouTube channel, then who is the owner of the channel, what is the name of the channel, and when you have retrieved it, because channel may remain, may not remain. If it is a mobile app, you need to refer the developer of that app, then the title of that app in italics, and from where you have downloaded the URL at that app store. So dear friends, for developing this short video, I have used a lot of material. Mostly I have taken directly from apastyle, apa.org. You can also visit these websites. I have taken some example from Scriber. I have given the reference on the pages for that. For more details, you are suggested to read the manual or see the tutorials, which are freely available on https://apastyle.apa.org/index. There are tutorials. There are more than 100 examples of referencing. So whenever you face any problem, visit the website, see the example, and refer accordingly. Thank you very much.